Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about finding the area under a curve given a z-score, or find a z-score given the area under a curve. A z-score is a distance along the horizontal axis of the normal distribution, while area is the region under the curve. And so the notation that I would like you to be familiar with is that if we're looking for the probability that z is between a and b, we use the a is less than z is less than b. For the probability that z is greater than a, we use greater than symbol, and for less than, we use a less symbol. We're going to use TI-36X Pro for these examples, but you could also use StatCrunch, and I've listed out the steps that we're going to use in TI-36X Pro, the left side for area under the curve and the right side to find the z-score. So let's take a look at the examples and use our calculator for this. So the first one says, find the area under the curve for A, probability that Z is less than 1.27, and for B, probability that Z is less than negative 1.27. Always when you're doing these problems, my strong suggestion is that you first know what the picture looks like. So I have the pictures here that were, I created these in StatCrunch, but because I wanted to be able to talk about them in the videos. So if this is 0 and this is 1, then this point right here is 1.27. And what we're interested in is everything from that point back. So we're shading to the left because we're saying less than. And here we have 0 and negative 1. So then we're talking about negative 1.27 back here, and we're looking at everything to the left that way. So how you do that on your calculator, first of all, if you've done anything in your calculator, you may want to clear things out. You can hit on and then clear twice, and it's going to clear all the memory. So then we're going to go to second function, data. And then we're going to go one to the right, and we're going to use our arrow keys here, go over to distribution, and down to a normal CDF. That's like the cumulative area, all accumulating here to the left of this, and hit enter. The default on your calculator is the mean is going to be 0, and the standard deviation, which they're saying is sigma, is going to be 1. So that's what we want, so that's good. So I'm going to just scroll down till I get to the next thing, and it's going to say lower bound and upper bound. In this particular example, our lower bound goes forever to the left, so we have negative 1 e to the 99th power. But our upper bound stops right here at 1.27. So I'm going to go down into the upper bound area and put 1.27. And I'm going to hit calculate. I'm going to hit enter and then hit enter again. And that's going to give me a value of 0.89795, whatever. And usually, we're asking people to round to the fourth decimal place, the 10,000th place. So it would be 0.8980 in this case. Always, when you get an answer using your normal CDF function, your value is going to be between 0 and 1 because it's the area under the curve is equal to 1 altogether, right? So your value is going to be some piece of that. I can do the same thing again. I can just go down to solve again here. And then the only thing I'm going to do different here is that when I get to my upper bound, instead of being positive 1.27, it's going to be negative 1.27. And then I'll hit enter and enter again. And that gives me a value of 0.1020. And what you should be able to see here, did I get those two backwards? I put them in the wrong place. So this one, the area, is 0.1020. And this one, the area, is 0.8980. And obviously, when we have this part shaded, we've got a lot more shaded than here. So this is about 10%, while this is about 90%. So that should be obvious when you look at it, that I had them flip-flopped. Okay. These pictures I did in StatCrunch, but I'm using TI-36X Pro for these videos. Okay, the next one says, find the area under the curve for the first one, z is greater than 2.35, and the second one, z is greater than negative 1.78. So now we're looking to the right instead of the left as we did in the other. So if I was to draw that picture, It would look like this. Here's 0, here's 1, here's 2, and over here is 2.35. It's to the right of 2, quite a ways over. So we have a very small area that we're asking about here for area under the curve. But over here, I'm going from 0, negative 1, here's negative 2. I'm not back to negative 2, but I am at negative 1.78. So now I'm asking from here over, what's the value of that? So I can put that into my calculator the way I did the other ones. Second function data, distribution down to normal CDF. I'm trying to add those up. And for the first one, I want 0 and 1. I like that for that. Now here, my graph is going to the right forever. So it's the 1E99 that I want to keep, and I want to put in my lower bound here of 2.35. And when I calculate that, I get 0.0094. We'll see if I flip-flop those when I typed in the values. And for this one, you can see that it's a very, very small part, right? It's 0.9%, very small. This is going to be a very much larger portion of our area. So in this one, I can solve again because I'm doing greater than again. So 0 and 1, and then I'm going to start with negative 1.78. Negative 1.78, and then I'm going forever, so I want to leave the upper bound as it is and hit calculate. And that gives me 0.9625. Yep, I switched them again. So when I typed this up, I did some cutting and pasting. Looks like I didn't follow through. But we have to be able to see that the area here is a very small area. And the area over here is the larger area. So we'll just keep correcting that as we go. All right. The third one, I think I'll save the next example for the next video. All right, have a fantastic day.